Hi, it's Katie Kovalvik here, and today we're going to be talking about, for optimal nutrition, never eat the following foods. And part of my journey of healing my body after two consecutive accidents and having all these injuries was really getting on top of my nutrition. I had been mostly a sugarholic my whole life. I, you know, tried to eat healthy or whatever that idea was of being healthy. And to really get the results that I was looking for, because I gained all this weight, I was having all this pain, and then I was having fatigue and I couldn't focus. I was having all these issues, and nutrition was a big part of how I got my health back. And so it's really the first step is awareness, and then how to navigate and take out certain foods that are really just toxic. So the two things that we're gonna be going over today are enriched foods and fortified foods. So enriched foods, I'm sure you've seen this. This is where you process refined foods. During that process, the vitamins and minerals a lot of times are lost. And so what companies will do is add in isolated vitamins and minerals and make it sound like it's still a whole food. And we really need to stay away from these foods as much as possible, especially if they've been highly refined. And most of the time it causes this stickiness and clogginess in our body. So a lot of times you'll see this in pastas and breads. So we really want to go to natural alternatives. And then we have fortified foods. So fortified foods is really taking more of the whole and natural foods. And when they, you know, been through a process, companies actually want to raise the nutritional value. So they add in these isolated vitamins and minerals and nutrients, and the natural synergy is lost. And so when you have a whole foods, there's a, you know, there's a whole harmony, there's a whole synergy that happens when you eat that food. Your body knows what to do with it. And so through that, the isolation, like things like calcium carbonate might be added, which now we know that can build up and make calcium deposits in our body. Or maybe you've seen vitamin D2, it's been added. And our body, obviously the best way is to get vitamin D is through being in the sunlight and being able to get it through that. And the thing that we can metabolize is D3. So D2, our body doesn't even know what to do with it. And so just having these, you know, little things that we can be aware of, because there's a lot more here, because there's other laboratory foods that we need to avoid, like artificial colors and flavors and additives and things like that. But what are my top tips here? So tip number one is we really need to read nutritional labels. So the nutritional label is gonna be on the back of any food, especially if you're, you know, shopping more in those center aisles. So kind of just a rule of thumb, when you go into the market, the outer perimeter is usually where all the whole foods are. And then in the center aisles, that's where the refined foods are. And so you gotta read those nutritional labels and to be able to navigate that, because a lot of things like cereal, for instance, is very fortified. And most of the time, things like that just are loaded with sugar. And that sugar is really going to peak and valley all day long. So it's really gonna make it so we don't have stabilized blood sugar. So we wanna eat foods that stabilize our blood sugar, and we don't wanna have things that have high glycemic load that's gonna put us out of balance. And so those are just the little things when we read the nutritional labels to look at the whole label and to be able to navigate that. My tip number two is to eat whole foods. So really transition to this, and this was hard for me because I was eating so much sugar. I love, you know, baked goods and things like that. So there's actually ways to just start taking those out, and to know that after about 2 to 3 weeks of taking out these highly sugared, highly processed foods, your taste buds change. So things like sweet potatoes and red bell peppers, they taste like pure sugar. And that's how it should be in its natural form. Tip number three is healthy substitutions. You don't have to give up taste, and you don't have to give up your favorite foods. There's usually a healthy substitution that I go into detail on my website and my online programs, and it's really a new way to navigate and to add in those foods and just have natural alternatives. So these are just three tips. There's more here, but in general, it's just looking at how you can eat more whole foods. That's the safest way. And to take out those like laboratory refined foods and things like enriched foods and fortified foods. So I want to hear your comments. So leave a comment below. And if you like this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.